So good afternoon, everybody. I'm Manoj Pandey, Joint Secretary, Ministry of Corporate Affairs. And it's very kind of scope and very nice of scope to invite me for a webinar.
Thank you, sir.
I will focus on what steps the ministry has taken to.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you, sir. Thank you for starting the webinar, sir.
Ease of living measures which have been taken by.
Sir,
I will also talk about the several facilitating corporate hours. This will be the scope of presentation.
Yeah, thank you, sir.
Yes, Samini, over to you.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to today's webinar on ease of doing business, ease of living, and business continuity measures undertaken by Ministry of Corporate Affairs during recent times. A very warm welcome to all of you. We are nearing the lockdown period, hopefully, and we will be able to resume business as usual. Before that, may I request DG Scope to kindly come on the screen and share his webcam. DG Scope. Okay, I'll quickly run through the SOPs before we formally start. As of now, we have close to 180 attendees and the numbers are still rising. So we have already circulated the SOPs, but I'll run through them once more. This is a very highly secured and highly encrypted app. So this will be using a lot amount of bandwidth. Therefore, this will be best viewed on a laptop or a similar device, and the links have been shared with all the attendees prior to the program itself. Also, in case all the attendees are connected to the webinar through audio mode only, however, they will be muted. Welcome, sir. They will be muted.
Sorry, there is a loss of connection.
No, sir. Yeah. Sir, I was just running through the SOPs, sir. So to continue, all the attendees are only connected through the audio mode. However, they are on auto mute mode as of now, and their auto mute is being controlled by the organizers. And only when you raise a questions in your question tab, which you can see on your screen, then only once you type the question and we are ready to take the question towards the end of the seminar, then only the organizer will unmute individual participants one by one. Even when we unmute you, the attendees have to take care that they unmute themselves before asking the questions. And also, I will once again flag off this thing that this is a highly encrypted app, very safe, and it's a double firewall. Therefore, the bandwidth usage will be high. Therefore, I request all of you to kindly switch off any other app that may be running parallelly on your mobile phones, especially. Now we launch the webinar formally. Welcome all of you to today's webinar on ease of doing business, ease of living, and business continuity measures undertaken by Ministry of Corporate Affairs. We are pleased and honored to have amongst us Mr. Panoj Pandey, Joint Secretary, Ministry of Corporate Affairs. Sir is an IRS officer and he has served in various capacities, including assessment, investigation, search, and survey. He has been on deputation in different ministries and departments, including Ministry of Finance, Department of Expenditure, etc. Sir, we are extremely grateful to you to share your rich international and national experience with us and guide us through this difficult time. The public sector is ready to support the economy in every way, but we would love to have a mentor like you with us. So welcome, sir, and thank you so much for sharing your time and space with us. We are also grateful to have with us Shri Rakesh Kumar Ji, Chairman Scope and CMD Neyveli Lignite Corporation. Before we formally started the webinar, Rakesh sir was sharing some very good news regarding the corporation with us. And sir, congratulations on all the achievements of Neyveli Lignite. It's only under your guidance and mentorship that the company is able to rise through the skies. And we hope it continues doing so. And thank you, sir, for being with us and kindly enrich us with all your rich experience and knowledge. Welcome, sir. We are also extremely privileged to have with us Director General Scope Shri Atul Sopriji, who has been the guiding spirit behind this innovative effort of webinar series. It is his zeal and enthusiasm that has kept the Scope team on its toes and to experiment with different novel and innovative ideas, the webinar being his brainchild, which is in front of you. This is the fourth in the series, and we are still counting on many more to come. We are very grateful to you, sir, to share your rich experience at CMD BHEL. And that is an extra bonus for Scope, if I may say so, because he's able to he's able to guide us, and we are able to learn much more from him through his international and rich experience. Welcome, sir, to the webinar. We are extremely honored to have with us another board member of Scope, Shri Shakti Mani Ji, who is Director of Finance, Siemens Corporation of India Limited. It's under his guidance and rich finance experience that we are able to sail through a lot of finance webinars and seminars. Welcome, sir. Welcome to the webinar. With this and all the introductions, may I request Atul Sopti, Director General Scope, to kindly welcome the attendees and the panelists. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Samriddhi. Thank you very much. Good afternoon, everyone. And it's my pleasure to welcome all of you. As Samriddhi has mentioned, this is the fourth webinar in the Scope webinar series 2020. We are really overwhelmed the kind of response we have got for all these webinars. In fact, for today's webinar also, I was told that there was a registration of close to 375 participants had registered for this particular webinar. It shows the kind of interest it has generated among the public sector enterprise fraternity. Thank you to everybody. In fact, that definitely has motivated us to organize many more webinars, which enhances the excellence among the public sectors in the future. We'll be organizing this, and we'll be sharing with you the topics of these kind of webinars. In fact, ladies and gentlemen, before going further, Samriddhi has already mentioned about today's distinguished speaker, Shri Manoj Pandeyji. I'm thankful to him on behalf of Scope for sparing his valuable time. And I'm pleased to share with you that he has, in fact, yesterday also he was quite busy in office when we had the dry run for this program. And today also, when in fact he is operating this thing from his home, there were certain issues about the connectivity, because it is the double encrypted program which is being used. So please bear with us if in between there are some issue comes. We'll be definitely sorting that out whensoever it comes before us. Mr. Pandey has taken a lot of initiative in this area in the MCA. He'll be sharing with us, and especially in the ease of doing business. As you know, that because of the efforts and actions being taken by the government of India, India's ranking in the ease of doing business has increased substantially, which Honorable Prime Minister has also been mentioning in many of his addresses. I think we would be hearing more about it from Mr. Manoj Pandey himself. I take this opportunity to welcome Mr. Our colleague, Mr. Shakti Mani Ji, as well as our chairman, NLC, Rakesh Kumar Ji, who is the chairman of Executive Board of Scope, as well as the chairman of CMD of NLC. Shakti Mani Ji is the Executive Board member of Scope, and he is also a Director of Finance of CCI. Welcome to both of them for this webinar. Welcome to other board members also who have registered for this particular program. This very important program. Chief executives of many organizations, directors of many organizations, and very senior officials of most of the organization for spending their time and registering themselves for this particular webinar. As I was mentioning, that we organized three webinars so far. In most of these webinars, in fact, we had invited the external experts who had given us the kind of issues which are being faced and what could be the solution. I think this is for the first time we are going to hear from the representative and a very senior official from the Government of India, who will tell that the Government of India is taking the step, whether what's the kind of step they have taken in the recent past, as well as the step they are taking during this COVID-19, so that keep the organizations moving and keep the corporate corporations moving even after the in the post-COVID era. That's a very interesting thing. I feel that this particular webinar is going to be of a lot of interest to you people. Yesterday, many of you would have heard the Honorable Prime Minister of India, Shri Modi ji, when he was addressing on the occasion of the Panchayat Raj Day. He mentioned ki hum logon ne jo is COVID se seekha hai, wo seekha hai Atmanirbharta. Atmanirbharta, which in fact hints towards not only depending on yourself, but on the self-reliance. In the broader perspective, you see it's a self-reliance. And in fact, public sector enterprise in this country have played a major role in making this country self-reliant since the independence days. And we, all of us, are proud of it. I'm sure that we would continue to play a greater role in the times to come in the post-COVID areas also. And for that, Government of India will be providing all the support to us and will keep us moving in that particular direction. The presentation which is going to be shared by Mr. Pandey would be covering all the aspects of ease of doing business, ease of living, business continuity and measures undertaken. My request to all of you would be make maximum use of it. But please, your question should be limited to the broader perspective, not to the technicality or the intricacies or the interpretation of various clauses. Let's restrict ourselves to the broader issues on the subject and the kind of actions which are being taken. Once again, welcome to all of you for this fourth webinar of SCOPE, and enjoy it. Over to Smriti. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thanks for your encouragement. And as sir said, that Atmanirbharta hum sabne seekh li hai, and I'm sure our public sector will set an example in the post-COVID era under the guidance of MCA. Just to apprise everyone, we have close to 260 attendees with us right now. So far it's been the maximum. The last count was 225. So we have 260 as of now, and just still counting. I can see 262 on my screen now. So now I would request Rakesh sir, Chairman SCOPE and CMD NLC, to kindly formally inaugurate the webinar and address the participants. Thank you. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Smriti. Good afternoon, everyone. It gives me great pleasure to be amongst all of you today on this webinar organized by SCOPE in association with Ministry of Corporate Affairs. It has been SCOPE's endeavor to provide public sector enterprises with innovative platforms for capacity building and policy advocacy. And in continuation with its vision of providing a conducive policy environment, SCOPE has organized today's webinar. It is indeed a great effort by DG SCOPE, Shri Atul Sobti ji, and his team for tirelessly working to explore new subjects and policy issues that may be of benefit for the public sector fraternity. Undoubtedly, present times are putting a lot of socio-economic stress on the corporates and the country as a whole, but it is also true that government is working round the clock to make everything as smooth and functional as possible. Given the global economic slowdown due to COVID pandemic, slump in demand and limited availability of resources is likely to further decelerate growth in companies. This would make the role of public sector even more critical, as the private investment is likely to suffer in such uncertain times. At this point, the government can play a constructive role by introducing investor and company-friendly schemes. In this direction, Ministry of Corporate Affairs has been playing a significant role in promoting India as preferred destination for investment, and its role is further magnified in the present times. Some of the major measures taken by MCA include introduction of Companies Fresh Start Scheme and LLP Settlement Scheme 2020, enabling companies to conduct board meetings through video conferencing. Eligible expenditure spent towards preventive measures of COVID-19 has been included under CSR activity under Schedule 7 of Companies Act 13. The mandatory requirement of holding company meetings of the board extended by a period of 60 days till next two quarters, that is till 30th September. So it is a privilege to have with us Shri Manoj Pandeyji, Joint Secretary MCA. You know, on the one hand, government is taking a lot of efforts. Those who are at the helm of the affairs and crafting the policies to suit the environment for the corporates in this difficult times, the same policy makers are coming here and sharing, one-to-one with us. This is a great opportunity. I'm thankful to Shri Manoj Pandeyji for sparing his time. He has been on the other side of the table formulating these policies, taking a number of initiatives, especially in the area of ease of doing business. And today we will be getting a chance to listen to him directly. While it is important that policymakers make the business environment more conducive, it is an equal impetus on the PSEs to not only use them, but also be flexible in doing business by adopting innovative platforms such as digitization. Scope has provided us with an excellent opportunity to interact with the policymakers. Now it is up to us to make sensible use of it and be selective in our questioning. With this, I once again request all the participants to make maximum use of this opportunity. My best wishes for the webinar. Thank you. Over to Smriti.
Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot for your words of wisdom. And hopefully, today's webinar would throw some light, in fact, a lot of light on what the ministry is and the government has to offer, and how, more importantly, it will guide us as to how public sector can take a benefit of the same and arise in the given situation. Now, before without wasting any further time, I would request Mr. Manoj Pandey, Joint Secretary, Ministry of Corporate Affairs, to kindly take over the platform and begin with his presentation. Over to you, sir. I would also request all the organizers to kindly mute themselves.
DCI. And Samriddhi. Chairman Scope and DG Scope has taken beautiful initiative in organizing webinars for the benefit of the PSE, all PSEs and PSUs. It's a very good opportunity for them also to learn through all possible video, audio video, and electronic means. In my presentation, what I will focus basically that what steps Ministry of Corporate Affairs has taken towards ease of doing business, ease of living, and also the steps which have been taken in recent past. There could be interruptions in between, and so I will have apologies in between if you find that my voice is not reaching you. The agenda of the entire presentation, that what measures were taken by ministry for business continuity within the ministry first, because that is very important. To guide all CPSEs and other departments, how all the work can immediately be shifted on electronic platform in addition to work from offices. Then the second agenda item would be ease of doing business ranking and how India has fared in last few years, and initiative taken by Ministry of Corporate Affairs to further enhance the ranking. The third would be initiative towards ease of doing business and ease of living, where I will slightly also talk about authority called Investor Education Protection Fund Authority, which may be of some interest to all the participants. And then recent initiatives during this last 1 month for the benefit of corporates. As you know, without a vibrant corporate in country, the economy would not, the fundamentals would not become quite as strong. So it's required that corporates are strong, corporates deliver, corporates fundamentals are strong to at macro level to make it economy sound and fundamentals very strong. And towards that only Ministry of Corporate Affairs has taken various steps. If you see, it all depends on leadership. And I want to highlight this point because all of you are leaders in various capacities in your organization, and little foresight also. So I was under the foresight and visionary leadership of our secretary. We took steps right in the beginning only so that business continuity in the ministry is there, not losing a single day. So what we did, that we on 19th, we started planning how to continue with the work of ministry, because it was very important from various angles. When you will go through the slides, you'll come to know that some vital functions were necessary to be performed. So first step towards that was that from 25th March itself, the ministry was fully functional. And in fact, first set of meetings the secretary took, where some of the staff members or officers couldn't reach office, they were connected immediately through e-offices, VPNs, emails, and video conferences. So the meetings started right from 25th itself, where agenda item was set and work was planned. Field offices, because we have a lot of field offices in all state capitals, we have field offices manned by ROCs, and there are 7 regional directors also in the country. They were made operational within a day. How it happened? The desktops were shifted because they were all security hardened. As you know, it is MCA 21 platform which is driving the entire ministry, because all registrations take place on MCA 21 platform only. So desktops were shifted and VPNs were provided to them, and not only following the MHA guidelines, not only from offices, but also officers and staff started working from home. So you will see that all forms, necessary forms, were getting processed even during the lockdown, not losing a day. And beauty of the entire thing was that the field officers started processing the forms even on holidays because it was enabled. From home also they could process the forms, and to aid the corporates, because in between lot of activities happen on platform also, and all these, that nothing is manual, it's all electronic. So it was required that their system is enabled. Now everybody would be aware, and some of you, if you are not aware, there is a central registration center within Ministry of Corporate Affairs. Through that central registration center, the companies and LLPs are incorporated. Now it's a very vital center. Earlier, what used to happen, that there were field offices, applications used to be filed, and it used to take a lot of time for registration. I will speak about it later on also, but right from 25th itself, it was functional. Even on Saturdays, Sundays, and all holidays in between the lockdown period till date. And I'm happy to inform that when I'm speaking here, still CRC is working today, incorporating companies for the country, incorporating LLPs for the country. Then Secretary, Ministry of Corporate Affairs, took video meetings with CII, FICCI, PhD Chamber, ASSOCHAM, Chartered Accountants, Cost Accountants, and Company Secretary Association to solicit their views. It happened within 2 days, 3 days of the lockdown announcement, and all were connected through video conferences. Their views were sought, and later on, based on that feedback, some measures were taken. The business continuity in terms of presentations also continued on different subjects. In fact, different officers who had some presentations fixed for certain dates, they were able to make the presentation to the entire ministry through video conference mode and through other audio video electronic means. WebEx sessions were held for all the meetings. And see, again I say that it depends on leadership also. All emails, all grievances and suggestions were responded even late night, early morning, and Secretary, Ministry of Corporate Affairs, personally monitored all of them. So it was like the moment some email comes, some suggestion is coming, some grievance is coming, it was getting addressed. Now I will share with you one screen which will, whatever I am saying, it will get validated. See, one company secretary wrote on social media, in this lockdown period CRC is working so fast, that is Central Registration Center, company incorporated within a single day. Sometimes it seems unbelievable. So this is how, this is the feedback we have got during this lockdown period when we are fully functional. And when company is getting incorporated, certainly the activities, economic activities would also follow. Now I will take you, the participants, towards ease of doing business ranking and how India has progressed. Now these sources are from public domain. and World Bank report basically. As you all are aware, India has reached 63rd position last year. And
sir, you're audible, sir. Everything is good, sir. Can you please put your presentation on slide mode?
Okay. Yeah. Sorry.
No problem, sir. I would also like to announce that any questions that you have, please use the question tab on the screen to type your question. We will take it one by one. Over to you, sir.
So, if you see the progress card, the currency is World Bank report and images from public domain. Basically, image I have taken from public domain, but it's World Bank's report, where you can see that last year India's rank was 77 in 18. Now, in May 19, it was 63rd. So we have made strides not only because of the initiative of the government, but also being implemented by the corporates and the PSUs, because a lot of leadership lies there also. Because unless and until there is implementation, it is not possible to implement the policies. So implementation is very important. Now you see that quantum jump. It started 142nd in 2014. We have reached 63rd position. So it's a huge jump. And these are the parameters which in 2020 World Bank will be looking at. So if you see, it's a currency World Bank again, opening a business, getting a location, accessing finance, and dealing day-to-day operations and business. And there are 12 parameters which are listed on my screen. The first is starting a business. Why I am saying? Because starting a business is where Ministry of Corporate Affairs play a role. Then protecting minority investors. And also, if you see insolvency. So on insolvency also, government has, India has taken a major stride. And insolvency law is not quite old, but quantum jump in the rank was witnessed last year. Starting a business where CRC, Central Registration Center, is directly connected. I will now talk about Central Registration Center and how it happens. So right now, when we all are sitting in offices or at business places or at home, if you have system, if you are sitting on a computer, you can get a company incorporated with right kind of documentation. If it is there, you upload it and you will get it. The company gets incorporated in a day. In many cases, less than a day. So we have statistics to say that the companies are getting incorporated even in less than half a day. So that is this is how Central Registration Center is functioning. During lockdown period also, because of the commitment of the officers there, the center is functional with all with reduced strength. But throughout the lockdown period, as I said earlier also, Saturday, Sunday, working holidays, and today also they are working to get for satisfaction of the stakeholders and to get the corporates going. So this is how we have to, because it will help in ease of further enhancement of the position in ease of doing business ranking in for the world. Because if we improve the ranking, more and more investment will become, more and more investors' confidence would be there. Now, towards that, last week of February, Ministry of Corporate Affairs deployed and notified a new web form called SPICE Plus. SPICE is nothing but simplified form for incorporation of company electronically. So it's an electronic incorporation of company which is started with centralized registration center. Earlier, the complaint used to be that for company incorporation and name reservation of a company, it used to take months. Now it's taking a day and a half a day. Our Honorable Prime Minister also, when he went to USA, he mentioned about this. And actually it's working with statistically, you can see the statistics on our website, it will be there, that how we are incorporating companies in a day on an average. It's still, as I could show you the message here, that in this lockdown period, company incorporated within a single day. So CRC is working so fast. So this is a certificate here, just masked the name, etc. But this is the message we got late evening, yesterday only. So likewise, we keep on receiving this. Now the beauty of this is Spice Plus. Why I am saying, because it's possible that some of the companies, the CPACs would like to incorporate, or some of the professionals there would like to help other corporate bodies to incorporate a company. Many professionals would be knowing, many of you might not be knowing this initiative. So now we Spice Plus form offers 10 services by three central government departments, Ministry of Corporate Affairs, Department of Revenue in the Ministry of Finance, Government of Maharashtra and Ministry of Labor. So all procedures, time and cost are saved for starting a business in India. The form was deployed on 23rd February. Thereafter, you know, because of COVID situation, it came, but still our business continued, and corporates and professionals also continued to file form for getting incorporation certificate. So it's an integrated web form, and through this integrated form, what you will get, reserve a name for a company, allot a DIN for directors, mandatory issue of PAN and TAN along with certificate of incorporation, mandatory issue of EPFO registration and ESIC registration, and professional tax registration of Maharashtra if you are based out, if your company is getting incorporated in Maharashtra, and mandatory opening of a bank account. And for GSTN, it's optional. So as on date, what is happening, if a company is getting incorporated through Spice form, it is getting a certificate of incorporation along with PAN number, TAN number, EPFO number, ESIC number, professional tax number if it is in Maharashtra, and a bank account number. And if it is applied, GSTN number, but that is optional. So a company need not, and a stakeholder who wants to incorporate a company need not go to different ministries and departments and agencies to get these numbers. So one certificate is getting all these numbers. As far as filing of mandatory forms concerned under EPFO, ESIC and profession tax, respective ministries and departments have said you get a number, but start filing only you cross a threshold. So getting a number is not an issue. You get a number, keep a number with you, and once you cross a threshold under the respective laws, you start filing forms. So it's a very big initiative which was taken. And we are in the lockdown period, we have seen when the companies are getting incorporated, we could see that they are getting, because it's a beauty of electronic platform, they are getting PAN, TAN, DIN, EPFO, ESIC, bank account, profession tax, everything while sitting at home. So there is no requirement to go visit any place. There is for all these numbers. So you are getting a certificate of incorporation in your hand along with these numbers while sitting at home, only through electronic means, no physical movement. Now I will, for the benefit of personal benefit of the attendees today, I will like to draw your attention towards one authority called Investor Education Protection Fund Authority. Some of you might be aware. I do not know many of you might not be aware also what the authority is doing, because the authority is new. But before 2013, as you are aware, if you do not claim dividends for more than 7 years, company used to transfer it to Investor Education Protection Fund. Many of the public sector units who are listed, they also used to do the same thing. So dividends and amounts used to be transferred to IPF and it was never returned back. But through 2013 Act, enabling provision was made and the authority has been constituted in 2017, end of 16 say, and this authority started working since 2018 after the proper constitution of the authority. And shares and dividends are getting transferred. So many of you, it's possible that your father had some shares, mother had some shares, you are legal heir, the shares were not claimed, dividend was not claimed by your parents, and the underlying shares have been transferred to authority. I request all of you to take avail this opportunity and get the amounts, dividends and shares back. It's all electronic. So you have to file a particular form and the claim would be settled. This authority also with a limited staff is working in lockdown period also. And we have transferred dividends and shares during this lockdown period also to claimants. It's a new authority and the system is also getting this stabilized, but within last 6 months we could settle around more than 8,000 cases with a market value of share transfer of around, we should say, 350 crores plus. So I request all of you, if you are not aware, go through the provisions of section 125 of carefully, not only from the perspective of your duty of transferring the dividends and shares to authority of the claimant, but also for your personal benefit. If you also have a share and dividend which is lost with the government, you can claim. Now this Investor Education and Awareness Authority also has MOUs with Bank of Baroda, Kotak, ICICI, CSC governance, and we are spreading messages throughout the country, along with conferences, workshops, booklets, and leaflets. Now, towards ease of doing business and ease of living, what the Ministry of Corporate Affairs has taken initiatives for both investors as well as for corporates. During recent times, in order to take care of the COVID prevailing situation because of COVID and because of economic slowdown and corporates are not able to function fully, some initiatives were taken. And the next, I think you would be interested also in knowing this, although they are all in public domain, but I must inform you all that since 24th, in fact, since 19th only, Ministry proactively started taking measures for the benefit of corporates, realizing the difficulties they might be facing or they would be facing in days to come because of COVID-like situation. So Insolvency and Bankruptcy Board of India, in fact, through regulations, ensured that a period of lockdown should not be counted towards the internal timelines laid down for the corporate insolvency process. Now, threshold for initiation of insolvency process has also been raised to 1 crore. So by and large, it will take care of MSMEs. Ministry came out with a form, Company Affirmation for Readiness Towards COVID-19, which was deployed on 23rd of March. This was a form was without fee and it was voluntary. It was only towards affirming that, okay, we have taken all measures, corporates have taken all measures to meet out the crisis, and also work from home policy has been initiated. It was pure voluntary, but more than 2 lakh companies filed the form within days. So that also shows the commitment on behalf of the corporates. Then the three professional institutes, chartered accountants, cost accountants, and company secretaries, contributed about 29 crore to PM CARES Fund. Notification was issued on 19th of March, allowing company to conduct business through up to 36/2002 to conduct board meetings through VC or other audio-visual means. So in the company's meeting of board and its power rules 2014, there is a rule 4 and it has been renumbered, and rule 4.2 has been introduced to say that for the period beginning from the commencement of the company's amendment rules, this particular rule, till 30th of June, meetings on the matters referred to the board may be held through audio, so physical presence is not required. It may be held through video conference or other audio visual means. Then thereafter, circular was issued on 24th of March, where mandatory requirement of holding meetings of board within 120 days was extended by another 60 days to 180 days till next quarter. Through that circular, the CARO order was also made applicable from 2021 instead of 2019-20. The non-holding of one meeting by independent directors during 2019-20 has not been considered as a violation now, subject to that they may share their views through email, telephone, or any other mode of communication. Further, requirement under Section 73(2)(c) of Companies Act to create the deposit repayment reserve of 20% of deposits maturing during the financial year 2021 before 30th April shall be allowed to be complied with till 30th June. So further extension was given up to 30th of June. Then requirement at Rule 18 to invest or deposit at least 50% of the amount, as you are aware of regarding debentures, in a specified method of investments or deposits before 30th of April may also be complied till 30th of June. As regards newly incorporated companies, they are required to file a declaration for commencement of business within 180 days of incorporation under Section 10A. And there is a form which is filed electronically. Now, an additional period of 180 more days has been allowed for this compliance. Realizing the difficulty of travel restrictions on travel, etc., non-compliance of minimum residency in India for a period of at least 182 days by at least one director of every company under Section 149 has been treated as will not be treated as non-compliance for this financial year. So that that measure was also taken, and you can see that circular was issued on 19th itself. Now, two major circulars, Circular 12 and 13, were issued to provide relief to companies and LLPs on two schemes, Companies Fresh Start Scheme and LLP Settlement Scheme. They were launched to incentivize compliance. Now, as we have issued a FAQ that is there on the website also, the USP of both these schemes is a one-time waiver of additional filing fee for delayed filings by the companies during the duration of the scheme till 30th of September. Thereafter, corporates will have to file a form after 1st of October and will get a certificate. of complying with the scheme if they have applied under the Fresh Start scheme. Now that will give there is a window where corporates and LLPs can come back to the system without additional fee, and they can become compliant with all laws. And both schemes contain provision for giving immunity from penal proceedings, including penalty for late submission, and they provide additional time for filing appeals before the concerned RDs against imposition of penalties if already imposed. So it's a big step which has been taken, and I think it has never been taken before. So all corporates, if they have failed to comply with law earlier, failed to comply with certain provisions, they should avail this opportunity with normal fee. In fact, I am not the concerned joint secretary dealing with this subject. The concerned joint secretary is Mr. Murthy, who is driving the policy. So I am, as matter of information, I am conveying that these initiatives, which have been launched by the ministry, should be availed, and it's an opportunity for all the corporates to come back to the system clean, quite clean, without any additional fee. Now, circular number 14 of 2020, dated 8/4/20, was issued regarding ordinary and special resolutions. So it was said that all decisions of urgent nature requiring the approval of members, and which will not involve the items of ordinary business or business where any person has a right to be heard, then the meetings can be conducted through the mechanism of postal ballot e-voting without holding the general meeting. So presence of members at a common venue would not be required. The four items for ordinary business, like financial statement, director's appointment and auditor's appointment, and then declaration of dividend, they have to go through the process as of now, through the process of ordinary business, through the process of other than postal ballot or e-voting. Otherwise, for all others, e-voting has been permitted, and a detailed clarification has been issued by circular number 14 and 17, how to conduct EGM. And for the companies which are required to provide the facility of e-voting under the Act, or any other company which has opted for such a facility. And for companies which are not required to provide the facility under the Act. So there is a two separate categorization, and a detailed clarification has been issued on 8th of April. Now, circular number 18 of 2020, dated 21st of April, was issued, where some of the companies who have financial year ending 31st of December as the date, then they can hold their AGMs up to September 2020. So three additional months have been provided to them, and it becomes now 9 months, and it will not be considered as a violation. So this is also a significant step for those companies, because many of the companies, such companies, would be a subsidiary of foreign companies also. And some of the companies have been following December 31st as the cutoff date for their financials. For them, it will be the date would be 30th of September. Regarding on CSR also, this subject is also handled by another joint secretary, Mr. Ganeshwar Singh. On CSR also, circular number 10 has been issued, dated 23rd of March, where spending of CSR fund is eligible for CSR activity. Now, on 28th March, it was clarified that any contribution made by companies to PM CARES fund qualifies as admissible expenditure towards fulfilling the CSR obligation. And a detailed FAQ has also been issued when the queries like salaries, ex gratia payment, etc. have been addressed, including the contribution to CM Relief Fund or contribution to Disaster Management Authority. So that FAQ also adequately clarifies the queries being raised by the corporates. In between, all these measures, I'm saying this has been taken, if you see the dates, quickly to address the problems of the corporate houses and to take care of business continuity. As business continuity measure, I also like to highlight one report. In between, a committee of experts, which was constituted last year in September, on valuation matters. During this period only, the committee of experts also submitted a report. So the ministry was working along with a draft bill, and that draft bill also has been placed in public domain. So what I want to highlight that all policy measures were being taken by the ministry in between, and business continuity was maintained as usual. This bill provides for corporates, it would be very important, because valuation is a very, very important issue. The bill provides for establishment of a National Institute of Valuation, which shall register and regulate valuer institutes, valuation professional organizations, and the valuers. Now, valuer institutes would be recognized by NIB, and they will conduct a screening and examination for admission to courses. It's a report of committee of experts and the draft bill. So it's a report basically at present. And the VPOs, valuation professional organization, shall focus on the development of the members. National Institute shall only regulate those persons who register with them as a valuer on meeting the requirement and having enrolled with a VPO. So the entire ecosystem is envisaged to have four elements: NIV, the valuers, the valuer institutes, and VPOs. To begin with, three asset classes, namely land and building, plant and machinery, and financial assets, would be covered. As you are aware, this work at present is being done by IBBI under company law. But in days to come, the framework is to cover all the valuers who are valuing different subjects. So that has been placed in public domain in last week, and the comments we are inviting. And this is all about my presentation. What I wanted to convey through this presentation, two significant things. One, that business continuity in Ministry of Corporate Affairs remained with limited strength even during the lockdown period. There was no stop. Second, all important decisions were taken, and in days to come, because the feedback is still being taken by other colleagues and the joint secretaries, and secretary is interacting with professional institutes, and secretary is interacting with all heads of trade bodies, all corporates, to further understand their problems and how to address them. I also wanted to sensitize you about the functioning of CRC and Investor Education Protection Fund Authority. Here, I think I will conclude my presentation, and I'll request the informed audience here, because they are all from corporate, so they are doing this secretarial practice. They are also helping the corporates, and they have, if certain policy questions, if they are there, I think they should come to ministry through representation or through inviting our attention of JS policy, as well as JS who is looking after CSR, if you have some concerns there, and it can be addressed. If any questions, if some of the attendees would like to ask from me, I would be happy to answer, provided I said the policy issues and CSR issues, and the policy measures, it should be best sent to the ministry by way of representation or by way of a detailed note what else ministry can do, so that there is a informed decision by the other colleagues. Only thing that I while concluding, I should stress upon, that the Secretary Ministry of Properties, right since beginning, the Secretary proactively is addressing all these issues and is addressing the concerns of CSR through number of circulars. And you can see the number of circulars which have been issued in last 1 month. Thank you very much for patiently hearing me. And I have taken, I think, more time than allotted to me. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much, sir, for a wonderful, crisp and precise presentation. Sir, in this period of negativity, the MCA efforts are definitely a ray of hope for all the corporates, especially the public sector. The fact that MCA stands strong with the corporates is a big support and a hand on the shoulder for all of us. So thank you, sir. Thank you again for taking our time. Before I start taking the questions, we have a couple in our question tab. I would once again announce that we will be taking questions for only 15 minutes. So with whatever comes to us within 15 minutes, we'll be taking it up. And we will try to patch in as many attendees on the call as possible. But just ensure that your bandwidth is strong enough to support the patch in. Pandey sir, can I request you to please stop sharing the screen so that the speakers can
see? I'm.
Yeah. And so the very first question. So the very first question we have is: will the presentation be available to the participants?
Yeah. I'll send across a presentation to you, Samriddhi.
Yes, sir.
I'll send it to you.
Okay. So I think two, three questions get answered there, that the presentation will be shared with the participants. The only request is that we would require correct email IDs. So kindly ensure that the email IDs are sent to the contact persons provided to you in the letter. I'll repeat the email once more, hrscope.khan@gmail.com. hrscope.khan@gmail.com. Once more, for everyone's benefit, hrscope.khan@gmail.com. Whatever requests we receive on this email ID, we'll be sharing the presentation only with them. So please send a request on this email ID. DG Scope wants to say something, sir. Over to you.
Samriddhi, along with their own email, they should give their mobile phone numbers also, so that we'll create a WhatsApp group of the people who have attended. And if further any information we get from MCA, we can pass on to them through the WhatsApp group also. So please give your phone numbers also, so that will be better communication.
All the participants, hope you share your correct email IDs and phone numbers with us for us to keep you connected with all the developments. Now we'll take the very first question from Mr. Simanchal Acharya. Organizers, can we patch him in? Can we patch his audio? He is the DGM CP from IREL, Mumbai. He is with us from Mumbai. Are you please confirm if we are patching him? sir, in the meantime, DG sir has one question. Probably he can put it up.
Yeah.
Pandeji, excellent presentation. I'll say excellent, and everybody has definitely got benefited with the presentation, the kind of actions which are being taken by Government of India in this difficult time. One question is, in fact, bothering everybody's mind. And in fact, I also mentioned in my address initially, people are feeling, in fact, especially the PSC fraternity is feeling, that there is likelihood of shift of business to the country like India. Now the point is, what steps, many people have asked this question, what steps Government of India is contemplating or likely to take so that India becomes the preferred destination for shifting of this business to India in form of ease of doing business as compared to other countries, especially from countries like Vietnam, etc. So I think 3-4 people have asked this question.
Yeah, I know, but multiple steps would be required. So Ministry of Corporate Affairs, DIPP, Ministry of Finance, Department of Economic Affairs, so all ministries and departments would be working on that. So maybe, see, I can give my opinion or view, but that cannot be taken as the view of the government as such, because this has to be a multi-pronged approach. One ministry cannot take this initiative alone. But see, the way government has responded in last 30-40 days, you can see one, that is why I wanted to highlight how it can investment destination. First point, which I said, that what you would like to have is to start a business, that there should be hassle-free incorporation. That we have ensured. That suppose you are in Vietnam, you want to incorporate a company in India, electronically you can do, you need not come. So you landing in Delhi with certificate of incorporation and all bank account numbers, everything is with you. So it's a big step which has been taken. You did not approach other agencies, other regulators. It's like a single window system which has been created. So first step is that, which has already been taken by Ministry of Corporate Affairs. Government, I think there is a lot of discussion which would be and which is going on, where ideas from CPACs and particularly who are heading the organizations or who had head in the past, like Mr. Sopi, they have to proactively convey their ideas to the government. It's very important. See, I can say one thing, that the feedback which comes to the government is taken into account while coming up with a policy or a policy measure. Unless and until ideas reach government, they cannot be implemented. That is why ideas are always invited from the government side, that please give your thoughts so that it can be implemented. But this is a question I think all ministries will have to address. So from Ministry of Corporate Affairs, we have said insolvency, we have taken a lot of steps. Incorporation, a lot of steps have been taken. And see, one in the Company Act, if you know, a bill has been already, amendment bill is there, where decriminalization of offense is the main thing. So all would become, many of the offenses which are there in the Companies Act would be decriminalized. I think all these steps would lead to big investments coming in India. Now suppose Ministry of Finance, Department of Revenue would also be taking some measures towards taxation, and they have already taken. The Finance Minister had already taken a step towards reduction in corporate houses, as you all are aware. So these steps are being taken, and see, the young population of this country now, even I do not know, during COVID-19 situation, because of our age profile also, we are better off than other countries.
Yes.
I think with right kind of policy which government is already taking and right set of implementation, India is bound to become a favorite destination in days to come. Now 63rd position this year, the target is come within 50, but I do not know how the ranking would be done because of this COVID, etc., because all the countries, even the developed countries, are in basically in acute problem. So I think I request through scope or through scope also, the idea should come to the government. Whatever the feedback you are receiving from CPACs, you should also proactively write to the government.
Very good point, sir. I like to inform all the participants that we have written letters to all the chief executives or all the CPSCs to give the suggestions in this regard, that what role CPSC can play in accelerating the industrial growth in the organization and take benefit of these opportunities out of this crisis. I request the participants who are all of you are very senior people to give your ideas, suggestions. And already we have taken 2-3 ideas with the respective ministry. Please give it to us. And government is very receptive at the moment. And whatsoever ideas you will give, we will take it up for implementation. Thank you, Pandeji, for this very positivity.
Thank you, Mr. Sopti.
Thank you, sir. Sir, we have another question from Mr. Jasbinder. My organizers have just told me that he's unmuted. Mr. Jasbinder? Mr. Jasbinder, can we hear you? Please unmute yourself. Okay, sir, I don't think he's there. I would like to ask a question that Mr. Rajesh Sinha has put up. We're not able to pass him through. His question is, I quote, "Sir, profession tax registration is only valid in case of Maharashtra or any other state."
No, right now we have implemented only in Maharashtra, because what used to happen, through this form, we wanted to first integrate with one state government. As you know, Samriddhi,
yes, sir,
the integration on electronic platform is not easy. It's a very, very difficult task.
Yes, sir.
One form on one system, MCA21 platform, is integrating with ESIC, EPFO, banks, different banks, not one bank, different banks, then GSTN, Income Tax Department. And we wanted to integrate with other states like Karnataka also, who are having professional tax registration facilities, or they want to. They have a PTRC or PTEC kind of numbers. So certainly we will like to go to Karnataka and other states where the numbers have to be taken by the companies. Like PTEC, I think, is compulsory. Thereafter threshold, PTRC is also required. So Karnataka government has approached us. We are in discussion. But as I said, see, there are two parts to this. One, that it's all electronic platform, so it's helping us in a way that even if we are physically, our people are not present, it's happening. All integration is possible and companies are getting all those numbers while sitting at home, while sitting at remote places also. But you will certainly appreciate that physical presence gives a psychological boost, that okay, I could meet a person and I could convey this. So that could have happened faster. Nevertheless, I think for professional tax, we will certainly like to go to other states also in days to come.
Right, sir. As you said, sir, online integration and getting everything on system will definitely take time, but it will happen. So
Mr. Sopti and Mr. Rakesh Kumar, his chairman, spoke. Can you guess a number? How many companies are incorporated on MCA 21 platform per day? Anybody can guess?
Per day.
per day. I'll ask per day, per month, and per year.
I don't
electronically, electronically through a single form per day. On an average, time is 1 day, and per day, how many companies are getting incorporated? So then you will realize the potential in this country and how the economic progress is taking place and how fast our central registration center is addressing this issue.
Yeah, please enlighten us.
Let me inform you. See, we incorporate, India incorporates centrally, there is no other facility now, centrally on an average 10,000 companies per month, which takes us to around 120,000 to 130,000 companies per year. And per day, even during COVID period, see the leanest of COVID period on Sunday, we had company incorporation of around 200.
Great.
Ranging between 100 and 200 during lockdown also. So this is the number, and you can imagine the platform integrating with all other departments and ministries. So it's a very big initiative through towards e-governance. And if you see other countries, I do not know the other countries would have this number, this kind of number which we are having. Barring New Zealand, which I know, where there is a common number kind of thing which they allot to all companies, because the company is also not very big. No other company gives so much facilities on one form. And we thought that whether we will be able to successful or not. But again, leadership comes, and then our secretary one day said that champions are not made like this. Champions have to struggle, and then they have to come out. Then and the form is stabilized as of now. And it's sometimes that's why I say the leadership counts and the vision counts. So if you have a vision, if you have a leadership, and you say that, okay, this has to be done. We were quite apprehensive whether it would happen or not, but it happened. We are getting all these numbers, and it's during COVID period, I am saying. During lockdown period also, it's functional. And this is the beauty of electronic system. So takeaway of this COVID could be, that is why I also wanted to highlight business continuity measures, how to use electronic means now to do our business. Some of the companies which have to mandatorily go to the field, it's unavoidable. But most of the business can be shifted to electronic platform. All the meetings can be conducted. There is no need to have such a big meeting. Seminars, like, suppose I am speaking to 250 or 270 or 280 attendees, your scope hall would also have accommodated the same number. I have been part of a lot of seminars and conferences there. So you are cutting down on your refreshments, lunch, tea, and the travel. Traveling allowance of lot of attendees, the vehicles, pollution, the papers, pen, and still it remains the same. Information is reaching to everybody, isn't it?
Here, as sir, I want to share one thing. That scope is losing its revenue also, because are hosting this webinars free of cost. But it is a matter of pride that we are able to take some initiative to enhance the learning amongst ourselves. And here I would like to share one thing, that this COVID-19 has thrown a wonderful opportunity to all of us to learn, focus on our niche areas. and equip ourselves to do a lot more after the lockdown period. And as Smriti was also mentioning, I just wanted to share one good news that you are right that while people are doing table work through electronic means, they are achieving a lot of results. But our company has completed the pre-mining activities in Odisha, and from tomorrow we are going to start our 20 million ton coal mine in Odisha, which will start
Congratulations. Big congratulations.
Yeah. So all this is happening because every day we are connected to the site, we are resolving issues, taking up the matters with the authorities also, and it is a wonderful opportunity. At this point of time, we can set up meetings with authorities without any hassles, and this is one of the examples that we could avail your time also for this webinar. Thank you.
Yeah, see, many of the video conference meetings are taking place, and they are very, very fruitful. And see, it's been a lot of time and resources for everybody. So what I am saying is, sometimes the problem through the solution also, and it will be a new life now after a new norm, a new life after this lockdown period, hopefully, when you will have innovative solutions all over in the government, among corporates.
Absolutely. I'd like to add here one thing, Samriddhi, just for the information of the panelists and the participants. The next webinar which we are going to have a very interesting theme. In fact, on the same line which Mr. Pandey was mentioning and Mr. Rakesh Kumar was also mentioning, the topic is going to be there, future of work in new normals. That's the CPSC perspective. So that's the topic which we have taken. So that would be on 30th we are going to have. Yes, Samriddhi,
no
questions? Sorry.
I think first of all, let me compliment Scope and CPAC. CPAC's, the number which I have, I might be wrong on our corporate filings. I think there are 2,500 active state government and public central government companies which are doing the filings. And all the resources, the revenues are so valuable to this nation. If they combine together and work together towards a goal of making this country's economy fundamental, which already they are doing, and no Maharatnas, no Ratnas, Mini Ratnas, they are already there. So I do not see any problem in getting country to a place where the Honorable Prime Minister always says that by 2024 will be $5 trillion economy. Maybe COVID would throw a different kind of challenge because of realignment of resources, etc. But still, CPSEs have a big role to play in economy.
Absolutely. Hello? Sir, I'm sure we'll definitely live up to the expectations of the government and to our own expectations. With this, we have Mr. Alok Gupta online. Yeah. Mr. Alok from Indian Oil.
Yeah.
So, Mr. Alok, your question, please.
Yeah, Ms. Samriddhi, thank you very much. First of all, my thanks to Mr. Pandey for giving such a wonderful presentation on the special measures taken on account of COVID. My question is, actually, let me first introduce myself. I am Deputy General Manager Materials at Indian Oil Haldia Refinery, and we are responsible for ensuring the petroleum product supplies across the nation, and we are taking care at this tough time. And we are continuously going to offices on and off, taking care of all the measures required as announced by Government of India. In fact, as far as the product supply is concerned, we are continuously supplying to all regions wherever required. But one issue what we are finding that because to run our refinery, we need lot of spares or supplies, like running of our machinery, equipment, pumps and all. For those spares, we are finding concerns, even though we have been informed, understood by government notifications that the transport facilities have started. But still, we are seeing that once we are wanting to have, say, some consignment of 100 kg, it is not moving. The supplier says that, no, we are unable to move in a part load. I have contacted some of my friends in CII. They say, yes, we can move as a full truck load, but part truck load will not be able to move. Maybe I do not know how relevant this question is at this forum, but probably I think this MC also can look into on this aspect, and maybe some help can be provided so that we'll be able to do even more efficiently in this point of time.
What I know and what you also observe every day, that Ministry of Home Affairs and Disaster Management Authority comes out with an order every day, practically saying that this is relaxed, that is relaxed, because government is also concerned that economy should move now. There should be a movement on the front of economy. So that is why some of the services were categorized as essential, including yours. It was that the essential services are there and they should continue. But let us see, I will not be the right person to answer this question. But what I can visualize now, because the way restrictions are being lifted gradually, because government would also be, weighing pros and cons of the situation, that how and when to lift lockdowns from different places. But probably I'll not be right person to answer this question. But compliments to you and your team for continuing with your good work and the great work. Because after all, somewhere something is moving.
Very right, sir. As our chairman says, pehle India, phir oil. Actually, we really believe in that, and we are doing our work tirelessly all across India.
I know. Even many of the organizations, ONGC, as I was not very sure of the mining activities, but as chairman has just informed, it's a great thing which has happened, so that even the mining activities are as usual and it's happening, and so it's a great thing. Congratulations to the chairman. It's a very, very big
thing. Thank you, sir. I only will request, sir, if you can, from your sources, can get to the correct place.
I know this, all this feedback. What I think, this feedback we should send to Ministry of Home Affairs, because see, everybody is working towards all these solutions only. So you write to Ministry of Home Affairs, Ministry of Corporate Affairs, and Ministry of Finance also. Everybody would be too keen to help.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Mr. Alok. Thanks for your question, and hope you're finding solutions soon. May I request Mr. Jasbinder Singh to kindly unmute himself? He has a question. Mr. Jasbinder Singh. Mr. Abhay Mahapatra, can you hear me? Mr. Abhay Mahapatra. All the participants with a question, kindly unmute yourself at the organizer's end. We will control the voice panel so that there is no problem in patching in. We just patched in Mr. Alok. Can we have Mr. Abhay? No, sir. So in the meantime, I'll just put up a question that Mr. Sameer Jaiswal has put in. Sir, we have in fact received similar questions from two persons with respect to printing and dispatch of annual reports. Though I believe your presentation has it fairly covered, but in addition, if you would like to throw some light on it briefly, please go ahead, sir. Till that time, I'll patch in the other speaker.
see, that is, I think it's or some clarifications. I think on this particular question, I think this had come from other bodies also, and we are in fact at the ministry level, it's being examined that how to go about it. See, the AGM, it's all annual general meetings and printings, etc. I think some of these issues have been thrown to us by the trade bodies also. And in last video conference with secretary, I think this issue was raised by CII, FICCI, ASSOCHAM, all the last week. And I think it's
Mr. Umang Jain. Sorry, sir. Please continue, sir.
So many of the concerns which have been raised, let us see, because it's under examination. Or they may get addressed in a different manner. For example, the AGM, the last issue which got addressed of the companies having financial year ending 31st of December. So the question of AGM also had come, that whether it's required or whether the annual report should be printed or should be sent, and how to go about it. So in the last circular, it was mentioned that how AGMs can be conducted through electronic means, and how other business can be conducted if it is not in ordinary, if it's not ordinary business, through electronic means. So I believe, let us wait. This question, I think I have noted it down also to pass it on to my colleague joint secretaries. And still government will come out with more clarifications in days to come.
Absolutely, yeah. Sir, it's completely understandable. You may not have all the answers, but the fact that you will be able to guide us and take them to the right.
Yeah, this point person, I got it, and earlier also this was raised. Yeah.
Absolutely, so much appreciated. We have with us Mr. Umang Jain. Mr. Umang Jain, can you unmute yourself? Mr. Umang. Okay, I think he's lost the connection again. Mr. Abhay, can you please unmute yourself? Mr. Abhay? Okay, sir, till the time my organizers try to find another good connection, sir, I would like to take one more question from Mr. Bhaskar Sen Gupta. I'll quote him, sir. Dear sir, I come from shipbuilding fraternity. DPSU shipyards now have to face open competition. Our tendering procedure is very cumbersome. In Philippines, GFR price bid opening is prior to technical clearance. Can we consider this?
Oh, that, see, right forum to answer this would be Department of Expenditure, because they come out with this procurement policy. And second would be maybe Competition Commission of India. But it's in the Department of Expenditure comes out with all these circulars. And there is a procedure, we laid down procedure by the government and by the CPSCs also. So on tender issue, I think I can't comment, because it's a mandate of Department of Expenditure virtually, and maybe in Department of Commerce also. I should refrain from answering this question.
No, I think we will note down all these questions, and we should make an attempt to send it to the respective relevant departments.
Yeah.
And in due course of time, we will try to help our CPSCs to find the replies and take up issues also.
Yeah, so at one place, everything should be consolidated. Maybe it may be sent to Department of Ministry of Finance, Ministry of Corporate Affairs, Department of Commerce, so that they can take all the ministries can take a view on that.
Yeah,
It may be compiled, may be sent.
Thank you, sir. Sir, we have Mr. Hirak Ray. Can we connect Mr. Hirak? Mr. Hirak Ray, can you please unmute yourself? Mr. Ray, Mr. Hirak? Not able to get anyone online. Mr. Jasbinder, you have a question. Can you please unmute yourself? Okay, sir, I'll just be taking two more questions. In the meantime, if I'm able to patch in any speaker, it will be great. Sir, there is a question regarding this that this is from Mr. Kamal Kumar Gwalani. Good evening, sir. Mm-hmm. This is Kamal Gwalani from Indian Oil. Though MCA has given relaxation from certain... sir, we have Mr. Jasbinder with us. Mr. Jasbinder, you just unmuted yourself. Can you unmute yourself again? Yes, Mr. Jasbinder, please ask your question. Mr. Jasbinder, please ask your question.
Hello.
Yeah, we can hear you, Mr. Singh. Please ask your question. Mr. Jasbinder, please question poochhe apna, aap unmuted hain. Mr. Jasbinder, sir, you're unmuted. Can you please ask your question?
He came online after that.
Oh, he's still there online, sir. Oh.
Tab tak aap question pooch lijiye jo puchne.
Ha.
Last two questions, I think, Pandeji, last two questions we'll take and then...
Yeah, okay. Thank you.
Pandeji, last two questions you take, please.
Yes, sir. So, MCA has given relaxation from certain provisions related to board meetings. Is there any plan to further relax the provisions related to those agenda items which can be only done in the meeting? And such agenda items be circulated... can be approved through circulation. This is from Mr. Kamal Kumar Gulani again from Indian
Oil. Yeah. So this is what I said, that all these issues have also been raised by the apex bodies of CII and FICCI, ASSOCHAM, etc. So let us see in days to come, because these issues have already have been posed to the ministry. They are under consideration, under examination. So let us see. Right now I can't I can only note down this question. I cannot provide answer to this. But yes, government is looking, and government is keen to facilitate corporates as much as possible within the four corners of existing law. And even many of the, through circulars, through rules, the laws have also been slightly changed towards to facilitate the corporates. So, right now, let us see, because still many of the decisions, many of the issues are under examination. So, I think, Mr. Kamal, you please wait, because there are many issues still are under are being examined for and under consideration.
Thank you, sir. Sir, we have a question from Mr. Sameer Kumar Jaiswal. He is saying, do the new incorporated companies need to collect the hard copies of all registration certificates before actually starting the transaction?
No, not at all. So it's all electronic. You will get all the numbers. There is no need to take hard copies. Only requirement would be on the bank side, that if you have a bank account number, maybe bank would later on do their KYC for only to get the accounts operational. You are not required to take hard copies, are not required. It's all electronic. It reaches through electronic means.
Okay. So, Mr. Sameer, there is your answer. You don't need any hard copies. Sir, though we have many more speakers, many more questions, but I guess we need to call it a day. And with this, I would really like to thank Joint Secretary, sir, for sparing time from his busy schedule and enlightening us about all the procedural aspects of it. And before we formally close the webinar, I would request Shri Shaktimani ji, Director Finance CCI, and Executive Board Members to kindly render his closing remarks. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. It was a wonderful presentation, and you have given your time. And in this particular time, I want to thank yourself as well as the secretary for taking such a steps. All 30 productive days you have made it. Generally, Saturdays, Sundays, nobody used to work. But during this COVID times, I'm seeing 24/7, irrespective of Saturday, Sunday, even if it is a night times also, people do work. Sir, I have seen that, sir, actually there are 12 countries which have improved more than 50% of the ranking. India is one among them.
Yeah.
And out of this, see, India's changes from 142 to 63 is tremendous. And as also you have told, there are even the top 5-10 countries, their registration time takes 5 days. But from your presentation and from your statistics, 200 more companies have been registered in a COVID time, and more than 1,000 companies are registering every day, and they are getting registration within a day. I know that this 50 will not be a big figure. You will more go less than 30. That is a China's figure. So let me share the knowledge of another webinar. See, there was a question which is being asked regarding the business are shifted to Vietnam instead of India. So the webinar, one person has told, sir, when the house is burning, it is always the people shift to the next house. Okay. But they will look after that economics little later. So that's what they were telling. So as of now, the Chinese companies are looking at Vietnam. But the way India is progressing, the way India is making the corporate governance is at works. Okay, there is a tremendous hope that India will get the fair chance, and India will become a 5 billion economy, what you are talking about. Sir, we hope definitely, yes, with your all the support, with your all the, you know, the computer digital work, let me tell you, sir, COVID is not a threat for India. COVID is an opportunity for India. COVID is an opportunity for digital world. COVID is a time, sir, we never seen many circulars in throughout our life. We are seeing every day a home secretary is giving a hand signature circulars everyday basis, which is impossible in a normal time, sir. So the COVID has given opportunity to work better. COVID has given opportunity to have 250 people, professionals, sitting on Saturday second half and discussing about a technology, how to make a business better. That I said, COVID is an opportunity for India. Sir, I really thank SCOPE and SCOPE chairman for organizing such a wonderful programs. And there is, I think, a feedback form is also available, sir. I request all the participants to fill the feedback form. And I thank each and every one, a participant and the participant organizations, to nominate these people. And I want the people to propagate this type of business in their own organization also. So the webinar culture should spread off, and the productivity of the people, productivity of working should spread throughout India. So that definitely it's not only HCA, the organizations, the individual should also pave the way to take the India to the 5 million to 10 billion economy in the future. Thank you, one and all. With this, I over.
Thank you so much, sir. It's indeed been an encouraging webinar. Apologies from our side, we could not connect a couple of speakers, but hopefully next time we're able to do that. As said earlier, it's an encrypted app, so there is a lot of bandwidth issue, but we're still working on that, and I hope the fact that as Shaktimani sir said, that COVID is an opportunity for all of us. So it is for us. We are still learning and exploring. So from SCOPE side, we formally close this webinar. However, before that, we have a small poll for all the webinar participants, which would help us to analyze where we have lagged, and it will help us to improve further. So with this, we sign off formally. And thank you, sir. And we look forward to all the participants rejoining us on 30th of April with the future world of work in the new normal. Thank you so much and have a great evening. Thank you, Pandey sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Rakesh Kumar ji. Thank you, Director CCI. Thank you, Mr. Sopti. And thank you, Samriddhi. Thanks a lot. Thank you. And thanks to the attendees also who were there attending the session. Thanks a lot. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. So, participants request you to please go through the quick poll. It's a half a second job. So please do put in a word of improvement for us. Thank you so much.